This week at NASA. The three crew members of Expedition 23 made a safe return to Earth after their Soyuz flight from the International Space Station. Commander Oleg Kotov, NASA astronaut T.J. Creamer, and Soichi Noguchi of the Japan Aerospace Exploration Agency were met on the steps of Kazakhstan by Russian personnel, who extracted them from their capsule and helped begin their readjustment to gravity after almost 6 months in space. The trio of space travelers was later greeted in a traditional ceremony at the airport in Karaganda, Kazakhstan.
You hear the standard phrase, we got mixed emotions, but there are. We've given so much time already to this ship, making it work and working well with the ground and trying to be productive. We invested a lot of ourselves in this whole process, and it's kind of hard to let go of that.
Well, I'm happy to be here for this signing. The NASA Glenn Research Center is, without question, an amazing asset to our state and to our nation.
The Glenn Research Center hosted Ohio Governor Ted Strickland, Ohio Senator Sherrod Brown, and other VIPs at several gatherings to underscore the center's contributions to the state and nation.
This is an agreement that reflects our deep respect for the revolutionary work that is being done at NASA Glenn and the burgeoning growth of the aerospace industry in Ohio.
Strickland and Glenn's acting center director, Ray Lugo, signed a memorandum of understanding that continues collaboration on technology efforts. The president's budget proposal for NASA would boost federal investment in Northeast Ohio and create new aerospace jobs in the region. The administration's plan calls for the center to receive $2.15 billion in funds over the next 5 years for space and aeronautic programs. As this year's hurricane season gets underway, the Goddard Space Flight Center has unveiled for the media NASA's new Climate Simulation Center, an amalgam of supercomputing, visualization, and data interaction technologies. The Climate Simulation Center supports weather and climate prediction research by one of the world's largest contingents of Earth scientists.
The exciting thing about these particular machines is they are based on the Nehalem processors by Intel, and those processors are twice as fast as the previous generation machines. So if we can get something twice as fast, we can provide the scientists computing power to double their capability to support the really important stuff that's being done with weather and climate research.
Scientists will use the Climate Simulation Center's cutting-edge capabilities to research everything from cloud and hurricane features to projections of climate change for decades and centuries to come. Space is the focus of this year's World Science Festival in New York. And what better way to symbolize this large-scale annual science event than this towering full-scale model of NASA's James Webb Space Telescope? Set up in the city's Battery Park, the model of the successor to the Hubble Space Telescope served not only as the backdrop for the annual event's kickoff, but also as a feature for festival goers and an estimated 85,000 daily commuters. This third annual World Science Festival, what its organizers call a tribute to imagination, ingenuity, and inventiveness, aims at making science more interesting and accessible to the public by taking it out of the lab and into the streets, theaters, and museums of New York. Four student teams representing high schools in Virginia, Pennsylvania, Utah, and North Carolina were at the Glenn Research Center to compete in NASA's Balloon Set High Altitude Flight Days. Each team launched a balloon carrying experiments to an altitude of about 100,000 feet. After recovering their experiments, the teams presented their findings at the Balloon Sat Symposium.
And when I saw it go up into space, I was just like crossing my fingers that it wouldn't crash into a tree or something.
Oh my God, over there! Where? Oh my gosh!
Balloon Sat is sponsored by Teaching from Space, a NASA education office at NASA's Johnson Space Center in Houston, the Educational Programs Office at Glenn, and the Ohio Space Grant Consortium. Its objective is to attract and retain students in STEM disciplines critical to the agency's missions: science, technology, engineering, and mathematics. Officials representing Palmdale, the Dryden Flight Research Center, and the Aero Institute participated in a rededication ceremony to mark the reopening of Dryden's Educator Resource and Visitor Center. Housed at the Aero Institute in the Palmdale Civic Center, the center provides teachers and parents with STEM educational materials.
There are so many things here that NASA does that people don't know about. And so that's part of the mission of the Aero Institute, and part of the mission of NASA is to really reach out to the public here in the community, because this is our source of our workforce.
The Aero Institute is, I think, best equipped to inspire young people and develop this connection really to lifetime learning.
Visitors touring the newly reopened center saw a demonstration of Dryden's Digital Learning Network Studio. And that's This Week at NASA. For more on these and other stories, log on to www.nasa.gov.